Now, we've got a new idea for Springwatch this year. We've challenged some of our wildlife cameramen to go out and really get under the skin of some of our most charismatic animals in the UK. We want to learn a lot more about them, and we want to see all of the dramas that unfold in our lives. Our first task has been set to Charlie Hamilton-James. Now, you'll remember Charlie. He's done a lot of work for Springwatch and Autumn Watch before. He was doing the leaping salmon in Autumn Watch, and he got some tremendous pictures. But Charlie is a lad insane to be down by the riverbank, because it's there that he finds some of his favourite animals, including one of our most splendid birds.
Early spring on the river. My favourite time of year. And there's no bird on the planet I'd rather be watching than a kingfisher. Kingfishers are magical birds. Vibrant, charismatic, captivating. As the seasons move from the late winter to early spring, they come alive, and the river does with them. I'm back on the same small, humble river where I've been watching kingfishers for most of my life. What always excites me is that each year and each season, life on the river is so different, so unpredictable. There's one particular pair of kingfishers I'm desperate to catch up with. I've followed them before, but have no idea what they've been up to over the long, harsh winter. This is the female. I'm pretty certain she's the same girl I followed before. Mature, experienced, perhaps even wise. Female kingfishers have orange lower bills, whereas with the males it's all black, making them easy to tell apart. This is her patch of river. She's nested on this same short stretch for a couple of years. The male of the pair, with his all black beak, I know less about, but in many ways he intrigues me more. He was new to the river last year when the pair first mated. Back then he had to work tirelessly to woo the female, and he's going to have to do the same again this year. Once a strong bond is formed, kingfishers can mate for life, but they might try a few different partners first. So our boy is still out to impress his older, more experienced mate. It's mid-March, and the sun beats down. It seems spring has come early this year, and the river looks idyllic. But early spring is always particularly tough on the male birds. Kingfishers have a delightful and endearing mating ritual. It involves catching a lot of fish, which means that our young guy is going to be rushed off his feet for the next few weeks. Kingfishers always eat fish head first, carefully, delicately turning them round in their beak before swallowing them whole. This avoids spines and scales getting stuck in their throats. However, if you see a kingfisher turning a fish round the other way, head facing forward, you know they're planning on feeding it to another. To court the girls and reaffirm their bond, male kingfishers feed a series of these engagement fish to their chosen female. Our male is ready to go, but it looks like the female has made dinner arrangements of her own. He tries. tries again. And this time, his persistence pays off. She accepts the fish. Their bond is strengthened. Fish passing is a way of proving his worth. He'll need to support her throughout the spring, so wants to show her that he's got what it takes. He'll carry on this way for the whole season, delicately feeding the female. It's lovely to watch the pair in this intimate moment. Once he's confident, he's enticed her with his fish suppers. Our male builds up his courage and goes to mate with the female. It's a wonderful thing to watch and the first steps towards the pitter-patter of baby kingfishers. But I can't get carried away. It's still so early in the season and our pair have many, many hurdles to overcome. Who knows what the spring might hold for them? Right now, they must defend their territory and guard their nest. Soon the eggs will arrive, and as the spring moves on, I hope chicks will follow.
He's good, isn't he? Not only great behaviour, but beautiful pictures too. And of course, we'll be back with Charlie tomorrow to catch up with the next part of that kingfisher story. Might even get the pitter-patter of tiny kingfisher feet, mate.
Followed by the flippy-flappy of little wings.
And we're fired. Now, we've got another camera, another live camera, down here. It's about 50 metres away from our studio. Hanging down from the oak tree there is a monstrous bird feeder. It's absolutely packed full of sunflower hearts. And we would hope that that would be attracting birds. But I can tell you, if we go live to it now, there's absolutely nothing.
But there's a siskin in the background. Oh, don't know if you can see that.
But a nice male, but it's not what we really wanted, is it?
That's not fair, Chris, because it's been packed all day long.
But
we have actually recorded earlier in the day birds on it. Have a look at this. Look at that's more like it. Look at those siskins, Chris.
It's a finch fest, mate.
It's a finch fest.
Fantastic.
I get them on mine at home as well. And now, in a minute, look at them. It's the nuthatch.
See, that goes
all flew off.
That goes back to your point, though. You see, that's the adult nuthatch topping up. Yeah. So that it's got enough energy for itself so it can go out and feed its chicks.
Oh, look, a woodpecker there. The boss, really, of any bird table, isn't it? Everyone goes off when the woodpecker comes.
Yeah.
But there's a little siskin in the background there, hiding around the back, still enjoying himself.
Yeah, even the nuthatch would bow down to the greatest spotted woodpecker. Not surprising.
Well,
it's really well-armed, isn't it, when
nuthatches
it comes down to it?
They are, aren't they, those woodpeckers. But